It's that pranayama, that energy that you're creating inside of your body, not only just for muscle reasons and for toning, but also to clarify and purify your body. It's like a furnace inside of your body. And so it's really important in the Berry Method to be able to begin to develop good breathing habits. And with the board, it's a great way. And I'm going to show you one routine in a sit-up that I love to do with all my new clients, because the sit-up puts your body back in place. It kind of plugs everything back in the right place. And using the sit-up, you have to use your whole body. So having Mary Arlene's on her ribs, she's going to take a deep breath in. And we're going to start with our breath work. And she's going to keep her shoulders relaxed, and she's going to inhale. And as she inhales with her hand to her side, she's going to feel the fingers begin to separate. And as they separate, that expansion will occur deep down into the rib cage, down into her lungs. So you're going to breathe in through your nose with your mouth closed, so that way you can get that good warm oxygen coming in. She's inhaling there, and then she exhales. When you exhale, you also have your mouth closed, and you just exhale through your nose like a stream of oxygen coming out. Inhale again, having your hands on your ribs. You inhale, keep your body relaxed, and allow that oxygen to travel way down. So you're mentally thinking where your oxygen is going, and you feel that expansion. You inhale slowly on 3, 2, 1, and then the same pace that you inhale, you exhale, and you exhale on 3, on 2, and on 1. Good. Now we're going to take this a little further. We're going to get a workout with this using your breath work, and now we can work ourselves right into being able to recruit the lower part of your body to the upper part of your body, and creating that energy to flow from the bottom to the top and the top to the bottom. So this way, when you move, when you leave and you're finished with your workout, you're going to find when you're getting out of your car or getting up from a chair or walking up the steps, you're using your whole body. You don't ache as much. Your body has that kind of a buoyancy and lightness about it. And so being able to go into this really good workout during a sit-up will help to really stimulate all those muscles and appropriate receptors to begin to work together as a whole. Mary Arlene will now take a deep breath in, and as she's keeping her oxygen coming way down into her lungs, she's going to exhale. Let's go in a scooping first. She's going to come all the way up and just pause. From here, what we're looking for in a good scooping is that she's tipping her pubic bone forward, her arm gently extend, and she keeps her shoulders relaxed. So you don't want to reach your arm too strong where you're tensing up your shoulders. She's tipping her pubic bone forward, her chest to her pubic bone. This is going to really help recruit. As you can see, she's really isolated in one spot. That's just below her navel. And she holds that for a second, and she lets all the air out. So that way you're bringing your navel to the back of the spine. Having the slant board allows you to really isolate into exactly where you need to go to be able to recruit in that right place below your navel and really toughen up your pelvic floor. From there, she'll lay back down, bring her arms over her head, inhale. And she'll inhale slowly, like a sipping of the straw, being able to count and pace herself at the same length as then she exhales. Now we'll do a sit-up. Take a breath in. She's going to exhale. She's going to exhale slowly, focusing and scooping. Now she'll come all the way up, and she'll touch the wall. Reach nice and deep, and then she'll begin to come down as she inhales on 3, 2, and 1. She's done inhaling. Now she's ready. Her lungs are full. She's going to exhale. She scoops. She pauses and she scoops, recruiting from the feet up. She's lifting her body up. She's reaching her hand forward. You're using that Mula Bandha in there, being able to lift your pelvic floor up as you bring your arms up. If you find that you have to swing your arms to come up, or you're jerking one shoulder forward in order to come up, then take the board up higher. This is all about isolating and recruiting deep into your core, and there should be no compensation. It should be very easy and attainable to do because we're building muscle memory, and muscle memory has to be clear and precise. It can't be vague or you won't remember it. Coming all the way down, she's inhaling nice and deep, preparing her lungs and opening everything up. She exhales. She begins to recruit. It's all monitored. It's all at a pace. And she's exhaling deep. She's steadying her breath and recruiting in the proper muscles, along and also being able to direct her oxygen when she wants it to go. Back and forth, inhaling nice and deep. And then she'll begin to scoop as she's coming up, tipping her pubic bone in again and coming forward nice and deep. All that air is out. And then she begins to come back down. We're going to begin from this exercise. She's drawing from the energy of her feet, having her feet on the wheel, that support of pressing her feet into some type of foundation will give her the stability to be able to rise her body up and down like this, and being able to recruit from her feet all the way to the top of her head. This is a beautiful way of putting your body in that perfect alignment and begin to recruit your body as a whole and not as parts, making your body balanced and steady. One more time, she's exhaling, letting all the air out. Good stretch in there. And then inhaling through her nose on three, on two, and on one.